Hi everyone. If you like building realistic parks in Roller Coaster Tycoon, you've probably wanted to make a parking lot for your park, as they're a pretty important part of realistic parks. But building them, even in OpenRC T2, has always been pretty tedious. The tooling has gotten better and better over the years, but it's always been a real pain to make a nice parking lot, especially if you have a lot of vehicles you want to place. Today I wanted to show off a little technique for making a parking lot that's hopefully a little bit easier than what you might have seen before, using some powerful plugins and some of the new plugin architecture that OpenRC T2 has made possible. So without further ado, let's get started. All right, here is a parking lot I have prepared earlier. Obviously, there are many different ways to make parking lots in lots of different styles, depending on what you want it to look like, what kinds of pieces you have available. Feel free to build any parking lot style you like. It's not really what we're here to talk about today. We're here to put some cars on this parking lot. So we're gonna start by building ourselves a ride, and I like to use Steel Wild Mouse track to start off with just because it's got those tiny turns. And we're gonna build a station wherever we like, and notice I'm not building it on the parking lot, we're just building it nearby. It doesn't need to be on the spaces itself, and it's gonna be easier actually if we don't build it immediately on the parking lot, and you'll see why in a bit. What is important though is that the orientation of the track is going the same direction as the parking spots. So you can see here that my parking spots are angled so that the vehicles will be facing either to the top left or to the bottom right. And we want to make sure that most of the track for our ride is going to be facing in that same direction. From the station, we're going to build backwards and just go with a bunch of straight track. Do a tiny turn, do some more straight track. And we're going to zigzag back and forth a bit. The lot, you can see, it's got a lot of spaces. I don't know how many exactly because I didn't count. But you could easily fit dozens of vehicles on here. We're not gonna do that many today just cause that's gonna take a long time. This is more than enough track. So we're just gonna go ahead and connect it back. We're gonna need a couple of sheets on here. We're gonna use vehicles, show vehicles from their track types and disable vehicle limits. And I'm gonna turn my mouse car. We're gonna stick with, I like to use floorless twister trains. Simply because they don't have any invisible cars on them like some train types do, and they don't have any non-peepable zero cars. It doesn't really make a big difference either way, but this is just what I'm used to doing. And we're gonna switch it to one train with a lot of cars on this train. It says one car in the ride window here because the game still thinks it's a wild mouse, but that's fine. Now again, I don't know how many cars we're going to make, so I'm just gonna go with 60. That's more than enough, doesn't really matter. And then we're going to put our ride into test mode and immediately close it so we just spawn all of the vehicles but they don't move anywhere. Now we're going to need to get our plugins out. So we're going to need two plugins for this. There will be links to both of these in the description below. One of them is the Ride Vehicle Editor by Vassy, and the other one is the Traffic Manager made by me. This one isn't strictly necessary, but it's going to save you a lot of time of changing all these vehicles by hand. What the Traffic Manager will do, we'll start with that one first, is it can randomize the appearance and color of all the cars on this ride. And in Traffic Manager here, we can see we've selected the parking lot as it's the only ride available. From here, we can tweak the frequency at which each vehicle type will show up in our selection of cars here. So if I don't want any bicycles, I can turn bicycles down to zero. If I want more sports cars, I can turn this way up. If I want more automobile cars, I can turn that up. So whatever is available on your map, they'll appear here. Doesn't support all vehicle types, only ones that look like real life cars for now. Then when we hit go, it will randomize the appearance of all these cars. Now you'll notice the first time we hit it, they're all colored the same color. So we need to go back to our ride here and change this from all vehicles in same colors to different colors per vehicle. And next time we hit go, they will all have different colors. Pretty cool. You could obviously do this by hand with the Ride Vehicle Editor plugin, and feel free to do so if you so choose. This isn't strictly necessary, but it probably will save you a lot of time if you want some randomized vehicles. So now we can open up the Ride Vehicle Editor, and we can start moving these vehicles from the track here over to the parking lot. But before we do that, if you zoom in here, we can see that the vehicles all have the doors open, and they're gonna look a little bit silly if they're all sitting in the parking lot with the doors open. So we do want to have those doors closed first. So we'll need to close the ride when the doors are closed. It's gonna be a little bit tricky. You need to test and close the ride in a quick amount of time so that the door closing animation is over, but the vehicles haven't moved yet, and then quickly close the ride again. You might need to pause and unpause the game for it to happen. So I'm gonna go ahead and give that a try here. Yeah, see, I was too slow and the vehicles have started to move. So I'm gonna reset here. Okay, this time I was able to close the ride quickly enough so you can see all the doors on the cars are now closed. I had to re-randomize them with Traffic Manager, but that's not a big deal. So we're done with those, and now we can use the Ride Vehicle Editor to start moving vehicles from the track over here to our parking lot. So the Ride Vehicle Editor version 2 has this handy dandy pincer tool. And whatever vehicle you have selected, you just click the pincer and then you can move that car to wherever you want on the map. Doesn't even need to be on track, can be wherever you like. So we're just gonna go ahead and start moving all of our vehicles over to the parking lot. Real quick, I will point out that since our ride has some curved track in it, some of our vehicles are not going to be pointing in the same direction as the parking lot's faces are going to be, so we'll just have to use those for decoration elsewhere, maybe put them in some back lot areas, or we'll have to find some other creative places for them. Sometimes if they're straight enough, you can still squeeze them into a regular parking spot and it looks like someone who just didn't park very well, which is a nice little bit of extra realism. All right, that's all I'm gonna do for now. You get the idea. It's still a bit tedious to move, you know, dozens and dozens of vehicles, but using the new Ride Vehicle Editor makes it so much easier than trying to build a track over the parking lot itself and using it to line them up by dragging them around coaster track. So it's pretty awesome that that feature exists now in the Ride Vehicle Editor plugin. It makes all this stuff so much easier. One important thing to keep in mind, if you close or test or demolish or pretty much do anything to this parking lot ride, all of your hard work will disappear as the vehicles will all get reset back to the positions that they're supposed to be in. So make sure you are saving often when you do this so that you don't accidentally undo a bunch of this work. Even though it may be easier to position all these ride vehicles in place, you definitely don't want to have to do it more than once. And of course, finally, when we're done, we can go ahead and change this ride type to something else using the arbitrary ride type changes cheat. Change it to like Crooked House or something, and then make the entrances invisible with the station style here. Assuming you've moved the rest of the cars out of the way so that we won't be able to see the track that spawned these cars in the first place, and you just have a bunch of cars just wherever you wanted them to go. And that's it. It's a pretty simple process now. Again, it's really awesome that the plugin architecture has been put in place to allow this kind of stuff to happen. And of course, big thanks to Bassy for the Ride Vehicle Editor. It's a really powerful tool, can do a lot of really awesome things. I'm not excited to make more parking lots, but at least I'm dreading it less than I used to. So I hope you found this video helpful. Maybe it's inspired you to make some more parking lots of your own, or maybe some other kinds of interesting car decorations, I guess. So thanks for watching.